Hey, baby, and welcome back, everyone. Welcome back to Agrarian Skies. So, you may see a little bit of a doodad thingamabobbery behind me. Let's check it out. We kind of went into this a little bit in the last episode, but this here is going to be my limestone creator. All you need to power this is you need two autonomous activators. This one is full of limestone because I've actually already run it quite a bit. But what I want to do is then fill this one full of stone hammers. I'm just going to put one here for now because that's all I got on me and I don't want to go make a bunch. So yeah, once you do that, what you can do is turn this on. You just set these to ignore and set this one to ignored and it will start creating limestone. It'll just keep going until that hammer breaks and it will make limestone for days. As you can see, I've made a lot here and I've taken quite a bunch of it and actually put it over here into my furnace so that I can get smooth limestone and I can make cool stuff with that. So yeah, we're starting the process, I guess you could say, of creating building materials. My grand plan is to avoid stuff that looks like this, you know, with the wires going everywhere and the machines just kind of randomly placed. But unfortunately, playing Agrarian Skies kind of lends to that because you're out of you're doing things out of necessity as opposed to building things for a function. Well, no, I take that back. Well, you're building form. Anyway, you can't make things look pretty is what I'm really getting at. And I want to make things look pretty. And I honestly have no idea how this mossy stone brick got here. I'm not sure if it has something to do with this water, but this came out of nowhere. I have no idea where this came from. And oh, I know what it might be. It might be there was a water barrel here. I wonder if water barrels make mossy stone brick. They might. And if they do, I might be able to make a mossy stone brick generator, maybe. I'm sure there's an easier way than using barrels, but that's a thought. I just thought of that. I don't know. That's a thing. So ideally what I want to do is eventually tear all this stuff up and move it somewhere nicer. Move it into a warehouse, which I'm going to build. I'm thinking of building it over in this direction. I haven't done anything over here. I created this bridge a while back for no apparent reason, but why not build like a cool floating island out here that could be our warehouse and our manufacturing facility? So that's a thought, but we need a lot of building materials to even consider that. Right now we're making trees one at a time, so we're not getting a ton of wood, but we can figure out a way to make a wood farm at some point. But right now, what would be nice is making some of this stuff, hardened clay. And to make hardened clay, you need to make clay. And the only way we know to make clay at the moment is by putting dust into a barrel full of water. So let's automate a way of doing that. Before we do that, let me turn this off here real quick. Yeah, that hammer is already broken. So I need to hit high on that and hit high on that just to turn it off so that it's not just breaking blocks. Yeah. Oh, I remember. In the last episode, somebody in the comments mentioned that I need to turn up the input and output on this. Thank you for your comment. I'm going to do it right now. I forget your name, so excuse me for that, but there you go. Done. All right, so this thing is now accepting and expelling as much energy as it can. Our lava generator is doing great. I actually added a few more of these crucibles to it. And yeah, it's working good. This lava drum is completely full. So we're working at a really good surplus of lava. Very good. So let's get to figuring out a way to automate the creation of clay blocks. So the first thing we want to do, and let's start from the backwards to forwards, right? Let's create like a little area. Do I have any barrels on me? Well, we have this barrel. Let's go ahead and grab that. We'll grab this autonomous activator too. What I was looking for was some of these guys. Yeah, I want these better barrels. This is what we're going to use to collect. So if we do something like this and put a hopper facing like that, and then we can place our barrel on top of both of them like that. So that way when a piece of clay is created, it will go down through the hopper and then fall into this bad boy. Cool. So the next thing I want to do is figure out a way to fill this oak barrel full of water. I didn't take this stuff out. Let's see here. We've got a pulverizer. We need an aqueous accumulator. And I thought I had one. Let's actually look around and see if we can find one real quick. If not, we'll just borrow the one from our thing. Here's an igneous extruder. I swear I made one. Where at? All right, for now, we're just going to borrow this. I think I may have tossed it in a random chest. We're going to borrow this one. It doesn't really serve any purpose there anyway. Oh, shoot. Go away. Don't burn up my chest. Okay, so we're going to put the aqueous accumulator there. And we need some fluid ducts. Do I got them? I do. Luckily, I have that. So we'll put this here. And I think we can pump water in through the sides. It's worth a try. All right, so that filled it full of water. Cool. So this is now full of water. What would be ideal next is to put an autonomous activator facing it so that we can use the autonomous activator to automatically put clay in this thing. So we want to hit this a few times with the wrench until that little orange box comes out the back, I think. Yeah, that looks right. And that way it's now facing this water barrel. So this would be a very basic clay generator in the sense that you would already have to have the dust made, but I could then put my dust in here and it starts making clay. Check it out. It's working great. Cool beans. All right, so that is your basic clay generator. We want to automate it a little bit further, so we could put some of this stuff back up. We definitely want to keep this. I say we grab some pneumatic servos. Let's grab some item ducts. Let's grab this pulverizer. It's going to be the key part of this. We've got a hopper, and let's grab a bunch of chests while we're thinking about it. And let's figure out how we want to do this. So we want to pump dust into this thing. So in order to pump things into an autonomous activator, you have to set up the input, which is, I'm pretty sure it's blue. Blue is the input, and I think I set it for the bottom. It's hard to say, but if we don't see it on any of the other sides, that is definitely the bottom. Yeah. And this orange is the output. We won't be worrying about that, I don't think. So let's set up some things here. So we want that to go that way. Let's turn off this one. And let's put a chest here. Okay, and this chest is going to be the output of the pulverizer. As you guys can see, I went ahead and put some power going to the pulverizer so that it could be powered, obviously. So let's set up the output to the pulverizer to go into that chest. And we may as well turn other stuff off too. So let's turn that off. Let's turn the top as an input as well, because we're going to be putting stuff back into the system. And this side should be an input as well. So we're going to go ahead and put a hopper there and a chest there. And yeah. Then what we want to do is create maybe like a little feedback system, because we want dust. And unless we have sand on us, we're not going to have dust. So I want this system to be able to, I'm going to put cobble here. It's going to turn that cobble into gravel, and then it'll put the gravel here. The gravel will then be fed back up into the system like that, and we'll go back into the system, turn into sand, turn into dust, and we only want dust to go this way. We want gravel and sand to go this way, so we need to set up a few pneumatic servos to make that happen. So, and then we need to set the filter for these. My dog is making a bunch of noise, and I mean my Minecraft dog, not my real dog. My real dog is upstairs sleeping. Let's see here. Boop. And so we're going to put some dust in here and whitelist it. So dust will go this way, and this way sand and gravel will go that way. And we're going to whitelist those. So cool. So that's your basic system. We could actually go ahead and set this up to auto pull by doing that. And all we need to do now is maybe let's take like 10 pieces. Let's actually just take 5 pieces. Let's take 5 pieces of cobble and throw it in the system. So those 5 pieces of cobble will get ground down into gravel. Gravel will get placed in this chest and then pulled back up into the system and placed in once this cobble is done processing. So this is kind of a long process, but we can just set this and leave it while we're doing other crap. And that's the beauty of the system. So hopefully gravel will then get put into here. Let's cross our fingers that I did it right. Good, it's working. So now that gravel's getting processed down, getting chewed up, put in the chest as sand. So that sand will sit there for a little bit until this gravel is done. So this is kind of a process. I already said that, but yeah, you just got to kind of wait through all the stages. That's why I didn't put a stack in there, because we'd been waiting for that. Okay, so the gravel's done, and now the sand should go in here. And what the sand should then do is get turned into dust. The dust gets pulled this way, put into this autonomous activator, and yeah, it's being turned into clay right now. So we can see the water disappearing, and we can see our clay numbers increasing. Yep, there it goes. So it's totally working. Awesome sauce. We could totally just stick a bunch of cobble in here and let it go to town. We could also just put our sand in here and our gravel, just put them into the system, and they will make lots of delicious clay for us. Another way to automate this further, let's actually put a torch down. It's looking pretty dark over here. I don't want any mobs to spawn. Yeah, there's probably going to be some mob spawnage around here, so let's just light this bad boy up. Okay, cool. So we've got it going. We've got our kind of, what do you call this? This is clay. And now we have a good source of constant clay coming to us. We could actually take this and run it over here to the old furnace, put it in here, and have it cook up into hardened clay. Cool beans. Very nice. I like that a lot. I like a system that I can kind of set down and forget about it, and then be very surprised later when I come over here and there's goodies waiting for me to use. Let's see if we have any. We have a bunch of sand in here. Let's go ahead and speed this up one. Let's put this sand in this chest, and that will speed up some of this. Let's take this cobble out of here and see if we can get the sand to come through, or will the gravel come through? All right, cool. The sand's coming through. We can put this cobble here, and it will be inserted later. Nice. So, all right, so this should be making dust now. There's the dust, and there we go. It's working. Cool. So you could put a stack of sand just in this chest and get a stack of clay coming out the back end. I'm so pleased with that. Very cool. So that's made, and now let's consider maybe doing some dumb old quests in the book. It's quest time. Ding dong. Who's there? Quests. Oh, look. This one opened up. You're a Wizard Steve opened up. While magic is what led us to this current void existence, not all magic is flawed. Great mages can perform heroic tasks, enter the quest only you are willing, blah blah blah, yada yada. Alright, so it looks like we've got some stuff here. I don't think we're going to get into this episode, but it would be nice to make this. We'd have to make a Thaumnomicon and a sacrificial orb, and we get some stuff. That'll be fun. We'll mess with that later. We don't really have any room to do any magic stuff. Everything's so technical around here. If we probably made the magic stuff, this area would explode. So let's look into something else, but before we do that, let's actually have a sleep. We've made a clay maker today, and we're very tired from our journey. So let's sleep, and then we're gonna have popcorn for breakfast. Breakfast of champions, popcorn. Very nice. So yeah, I got this popcorn from the corn seeds I got in a quest in the last episode, and I've been planting nothing but corn up here. So I've gone corn crazy, got corn for days. So yeah, let's look in the book. All right, screw this magic stuff. We're still continuing to skyblock. And we've got a few things available to us. We still don't have a way of making this auto brewer yet. I'm thinking maybe in the next episode, we're going to visit the Nether. I don't know what the Nether looks like in this mod pack. I can only imagine. So yeah, that'll be a fun little excursion, but we're not going to do that this episode. And this one requires us to do magic, so we can't do that. So what we could do is this guy. Powering up. We need to make ourselves a steam dynamo. Doesn't seem too difficult. Let's do that. I think I might even have the bits and bobs for it. So let's see here. Let's type in steam dynamo. Ooh, what is this? A steam turbine. Cool. All right, I'm getting distracted. We need to make ourselves some copper gears. And we need to make a transmission coil. All right. So we need ourselves some silver. Do I have any redstone? Cool. So blop, blop. I haven't made one of these in a while, so this is kind of a good refresher. The copper gears are just that, so we need copper and iron. I'm glad they aren't like the industrial craft gears. Those are a pain in the butt to make. But let's make a couple of these. A couple of these. One, two. I don't even think I'm going to use this. I'm literally just making it for the quest. So, yeah, we might be able to tie that in. There we go. We got it. Let's turn in that quest and see what sort of awesome loot we get out of it. Claim reward. I love that little music. It's fun. Let's see here. We've got half a heart. Could care less. And we've got a good reward bag. Okay, folks, cross your fingers that we don't throw it off the edge. And we're going to throw it off the edge. Not so good reward. I don't even care what this sword could have on it. It has silk touch. Okay, we're keeping this. Never mind. I was going to throw it off the edge. But look at that. We can silk touch with this. Okay, so we've got a nice silk touch axe out of that. Well, it's not an axe. It's a sword. So it's kind of funky, but we'll live with it. We can then now use this to make more dirt. I haven't checked on my dirt. How good is this doing? So we've got two stacks of dirt. And yeah, I cleaned this out earlier. Ooh, look at this. We have some gold armor here. We could actually combine these. Yeah, let's combine these. And let's switch it out for our dirty old tunic. Look at that. Now we're styling. Oh yeah, baby. Wearing a golden shirt. That's right. Okay, so let's look and see if that opened up any other quests for us. If not, maybe we'll do some of the cooking quests. Oh, look at this stuff. We can actually get this one. All right, what is this one? A pulverizer. I've already made that. Ooh, look, we get a diamond hammer out of it. And apparently it's enchanted. All right, let's pick a reward bag and claim reward. I kind of have gone ahead in this game and done some of these quests without knowing it. But let's check out what's in our reward bag. Cross your fingers, something good. It's some crappy pickaxe. Click to close. Alright, so what does this guy got on it? It is a spiked pick. It is jagged, stone-bound, and thomic. Apparently it has a stone head. But let's actually compare it to our current one. So let's just try this. So that's pretty good, I guess. It seems to be about the same. So yeah, we'll just throw it here in this chest. In case we die, we will have it. So cool, that's done. More quests, please! Papa! Alright, so we've opened quite a few here, actually. Cultivating the harvest. Oh, look at this stuff. We can make Mine Factory Reloaded stuff now. And we'll get a flux infused sickle. And we'll get a bunch of damn seeds. Ooh, ender lily seeds. Those could be useful. Excuse me. We could get a tomato, a bean seed, or just seeds. I would go for these ender lily seeds any day. I don't care about tomatoes, and I don't care about no beans. So maybe we can try and make this stuff here. Shall we try and make a harvester? Do I even have... I have four plastic sheets here. We have a little bit of rubber. We should actually go ahead and process, like, maybe half of this rubber. And we'll turn it into raw rubber. And we can make even more of those crazy sheets, man. So while that's doing its thing, let's grab these sheets and let's look up and see what it takes to make a harvester. I'm not a huge fan of the Mine Factory Reloaded stuff, but it's going to be a necessity here on the old agrarian skies, seeing as we have to find ways to... What is this? Invar pickaxe, shears, redstone, coil, machine frame. All right, let's make this crap. Let's do it! So where is my Invar? I'm running low on Invar. I'm going to have to create some more. So I need wood, too. Do I have any just like logs? Here we go. Put this up. Make yourself a stack of wood. Make yourself a stick. And then make ourselves an axe. Cool. Alright, so we've got our Invar axe. We need to make two shears. Okay, that's done. We need ourselves a machine frame. We have two in here. We'll take one. We're going to put these hearts up, and this up, and this up. Actually, we need that. We'll put that up. What other garbage do I have here? Go away, Steam Dynamo. Okay, what was I doing? I'm making a harvester. Can we make this yet? We need a redstone thingy coil bopper. So let's make one of them. And then we're going to need some more gold, I think. See if we can just click this in. Let's make three of these. I think we'll need them at some point. And if I click this in, do I make it yet? What am I missing? What could I possibly... Oh, these aren't stackable. That's why it's not working. So two plastic sheets. Invar X. Shear there. And a shear there. We put our thingy there. I think this was just gold, right? And one conduit coil. There we go. We've got a harvester. There's my first harvester. I have never made a harvester before. All right, let's see what else is in the book. We need to make ourselves a planter. All right, hopefully we got the junk for that. One planter, please. All right, we need to make ourselves a flower pot. That is so funny. Okay, copper and more of these redstone reception coils. Okay, let's make ourselves a flower pot. The best way I know how to do that is with clay. Look at that, we've made two stacks of clay. So we put a clay down, punch it up, and then we take our clay and we stick it in here. Oh, looks like I already have some bricks in here. Never mind, I got them. Let's actually grab this stuff. I think we're gonna have to do an inventory purge here in a second, because it looks like a mess at the moment. So let's make ourselves an old flower pot. Very good. Okay, what's next? How did that go back up there? What are you doing? We need two pistons, redstone, reception coil, blah, 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 and all that stuff. Do we have copper on us? I don't think we do. Maybe we can just click this in. Cross your fingers. Nope, we're missing pistons, right? We sure are. All right, now we can shift click it in, right? We sure can. There we go, planter, done. All right, what's the next little bit? We need to make an Invar sickle. I don't think that'll be too terribly difficult. There we go. All right, three Invar and a stick, not bad. Awesome, we're making stuff we've never made before. So this will actually help us harvest our crops. I don't know why they make you make an Invar sickle and a harvester, seeing as the harvester is going to harvest for you. I don't know. I think they just want you to make stuff and learn things. The next one is going to be a sludge boiler. I don't even know what the crap that be. What'd that be? Sludge boiler. So that is two furnace, two of those, and iron. Ah, that's not too bad. If I could just get myself some cobble here, I'll make myself a bunch of damn ferni. And if you guys didn't know, ferni is the plural for furnace. True story. I have no idea, I just made that up. Let's see here. We might be done. Oh, we need to make some plastic sheets. Do we just do like this or something? There we go. Plastic sheets, this can go over there. And we might just be able to click this guy in. Oh, we need a bucket, we got iron. What am I missing? Are we missing a machine frame? Or... yeah, we might be missing a machine frame. I do believe that's what we're missing. So we need to get ourselves some glaze. Go away, stick. Ba-ba-ba. Machine frame. One, two. All right, so we'll put that there. Click it in. Ah, dang it, man. I swear this game messes with me sometimes. All right, so let's figure out what we're missing. Redstone reception coil, iron, two furnaces, and plastic sheets. It looks like I got everything, but let's do this. I wonder if it's an Invar bucket or something stupid like that. Two in iron. Yeah, do I not have iron on me? Oh, that's it. That's what I was missing. And I don't see any iron in here. Let's go over here. Iron is actually the one resource I am running out of the most. I use iron for everything. And I know there's some resources or recipes in here that, you know, you can swap like aluminum for iron. So I should really pay more attention to that. I think we can hand this one in now, but let's actually clean out our inventory of garbage. This stuff can all go away. All right. I'm going to get the Ender Lily seeds. What am I missing? Pick one. I picked. Oh, wait, there's more. We need to make a sludge bucket. How do I make sludge bucket? Probably with the sludge boiler, right? Alright, so let's put this boiler down and see if we can figure it out. Sludge boiler. Looks like it requires energy, so let's pick it up again. Sludge boiler, what do I do? That's not the sludge boiler. If I put that there, does this just make sludge, or do I have to do something to it? What if I just stand on top of it? Is it one of those things? Do I have to throw things into it? Does it need water? I'm gonna have to do some research on what a sludge boiler takes. If you guys know, let me know. Let me know in the comments. I don't mess with Mine Factory Reloaded a whole lot, so maybe it's one of these things. Do I throw popcorn on top of it? Will that make it work? What about carrot juice? Can I throw carrot juice in it? Does that make do? I just don't know. Do I throw a bucket of water in it? I would think you'd put some sort of organic material in here, and it would do its business. We could actually move it right here and see if that does it. I know nothing about sludge boilers, just in case you guys couldn't figure it out. Boom. All right, so it's not accepting water, so that's not a thing. So yeah, we're gonna have to investigate this. You guys are smart. Let me know in the comments what the heck a sludge boiler does. I haven't a damn idea. So guys, as always, I want to thank each and every one of you for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, give it a big old thumbs up. And until next time, we'll see you all real soon. Bye. Oh, my chest is on fire. My chest is on fire.